Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Hope you are all doing fine. This is Architect Aris Plaza for another video tutorial to improve your skills. But this time, it will not be Revit. I will be teaching you AutoCAD, the basics of AutoCAD. It's a good start if you are willing to learn 3D modeling using different softwares, and if you are willing to move into building information modeling using specifically Revit, and AutoCAD is a good start. It would equip you with the basic skills that are going to be useful when you move into digital drawing tools that would require at least a basic understanding of how AutoCAD works. So I'd like to thank my current students. I have a big class of more than 20 students right now who have just subscribed to this channel. Thank you very much. Don't worry. Even if my background shows that I am in a beach, I'm still in Qatar, and I will see you in our next session. It's a nice virtual background so we can somehow beat the heat even in our minds. So without further ado, I'd like to share with you my screen, guide you to how I teach the basic of AutoCAD. This is our first video, and forward to more videos to come. I hope you keep watching, like the videos, and share them with your colleagues and friends to start learning digital drawing using AutoCAD. Let's go. My AutoCAD classes are 3-hour sessions, and these are hands-on trainings where I lecture specific topics and make sure that each of the students are able to learn on that day. And I also give homeworks and in-classroom exercises so that the student will be able to exercise what have been taught. And so I'm doing this video for some of my students who would like to review what we have just lectured in the past few sessions that I've had. This would be for former students as well, would like to catch up on what we have discussed. And this is also for those students and young professionals who are searching for a CAD instructor online. I hope you get to learn from my lecture, and please share them with your friends. We have the same goal, and I hope to see you one day. When I teach AutoCAD, start with the interface and ensure that the students understand what we are doing when we are drawing in AutoCAD. So I'll just click Start Drawing here so that we'll get into the AutoCAD file itself. Yeah, you are now seeing the AutoCAD interface. Like the other softwares these days, it's Windows-based. You have these tabs from Home tab, and then you have this Insert, Annotate, Parametric, and among other tabs that are available. There are different ways to start AutoCAD and to do things in AutoCAD. But for us to be able to understand it first, let us understand the parts of the interface. What you see in my screen is the black screen. It's called the model space right there. On the left-hand side of your screen, you see there the model tab. This is the model pack, that the model tab. This is where we do all of our drawings. And the second tab here is the layout drawing. So this is where the drawing is placed in the paper space or in the title block, which will be ready for printing. Okay. By default, this template that I opened have two layouts, but in other versions, you will just have one layout. So for the purpose of not complete confusing you, I'll just delete the other paper space tab, and I'll just go back to the model space. So the model space is it's an area where you do all your drawing, and it is based on the Cartesian coordinate system. So let's just review a little bit of your algebra and geometry. So in geometry, you have y-coordinate as the horizontal, or the vertical coordinate, and the x-coordinate as the horizontal coordinate. You can see that right there. If I do a drawing, if I draw a circle, I need to press a command. Okay, a press or type a command. So the commands are located here. These icons are shortcuts to start drawing. For example, if I click on circle, then you have to go to your command prompt. You have to talk to AutoCAD in order to be able to have it function properly. So it is asking you specify center point for circle. So the center point that we'll define right now is 0 for the x coordinate and y, and 0 as well for the y coordinate. And I'll press enter. So automatically, AutoCAD brought us to where 0, 0 is. So right there in the middle of the x and y coordinates. And now I'm now in the process of creating a circle. Now the second question that the command prompt asks you is to specify the radius or diameter of the circle. So by default, it says specify the radius of the circle. So let's say we want to have a 5 meter radius circle. So we need to enter 5,000. 5,000 because the drawing units that we have right now is in millimeters. So I will type 5,000 and then press enter. So the circle that I made is a circle with 5,000 millimeter or 5 meter radius. So suddenly, I don't see any circle. For what reason? Because I am not sure how big my drawing area, how big the drawing area that I'm zoomed in is. So to find where your circle is, just type Z for zoom, press enter, and type A for all, enter, then is your circle. So now you know where the 5 meter boundaries are. That is from the center of the circle up to its radius. Actually, if I check on the measurement, you will see that it is telling us on the radius, AutoCAD is telling us that the radius of the circle is 5,000. Okay, so that is how you perform any drawing task in AutoCAD. You choose the tools that we have here. We have line, polyline, circle, arc, and the other shapes here. You have rectangle and polygon, as well as ellipse and other commands, another draw commands. And you have to make sure that you are reading what is there in the command prompt and we are responding to what it is asking us. When we enter anything in the command prompt, make sure that we press enter so that it will perform the task that we wanted to do. Okay, so let's do that again. Let's do a rectangle this time. I'll click on rectangle. Again, it will ask us the first corner point. So if I say 0, 0, it will start at the center of the circle. But we already know the 0, 0, which is the center of the circle. So I'll just go here in the center of the circle. So to make sure that we are at the center of the circle, we have to make sure that the snaps button are on. So maybe let's put on center is on. Okay, the snap tools are on. Let's go back to rectangle. There it is. It's leading us to the center. And then I'll just click there. Again, let's do that again. REC. I'm typing REC as a shortcut for rectangle. Then I'll hover here at the center. And I'll do that again. I'll do that again. REC, enter. Now this time I'll go at the geometric center of the rectangle that we did. See, if I hover here, there's a shape that comes up. No? That is the geometric center of the rectangle that we just did. So these, if I draw a line, for example, brings me to the midpoint of the line of this, of the upper line of the rectangle, and I can go to the midpoint of the other rectangle. If I draw another line, go there. So these different shapes are called snaps. Now you can control them here in the snap tool. And you have the different options here. You can make sure you can check those ones that you want to use. So by default, we have endpoint, midpoint, center, geometric center, node, intersection, perpendicular, and about intersection as default tools that are already switch on. So if you switch this off, I mean the highlight is not there, you cannot do that same thing. See, there is no snap symbol that comes out. So if you click that on, you see that snap goes there, the other one goes there. It can be the endpoint, usually it's a square, and then in the midpoint, this the symbol is like it's a triangle, and it goes to the geometric center, and then you go again to the other geometric center. Okay. So those are line tools. And this is the very first good lesson that would benefit those who will be starting to learn AutoCAD. There will be more in the next videos to come. So these might just be a few commands these are just a few commands that I've taught you, but rest assured, this is what you need to start off learning AutoCAD. Make sure that you press on the command that you want to do, and then be able to talk to your command prompt so that you can perform the task that you wanted to do, and make sure that you switch on your snap cursor. All right, this is Aris Basa, and I hope to see you in the next videos while we teach AutoCAD for everyone. Maraming salamat po.